I've made a lot of mistakes, especially early on in my career as a data scientist. Today, I'll talk about the five biggest data science beginner mistakes that you can avoid to enjoy a successful career as a data scientist. And make sure to watch till the very end for the most common mistake that you can easily avoid. I'm Samanvay and I'm a data scientist in Sydney, Australia. The first mistake has to be trying to find the best data science course. There's no one size fits all. Your data science journey will continue long after your course, and it's going to be a long one. Data science tends to be a very broad field, so there's lots of different technical and soft skills to learn, and it's very hard to find a course that encompasses all of them. So instead, just get started on your journey. Don't deliberate too much on what course to study. Pick a resource like Stanford's machine learning course on Coursera or a basic Python programming course, because once you get started, you'll figure out what to learn next. Learning data science is a little bit like putting together a jigsaw puzzle. Every single piece is a new skill that you need to know. And in my honest opinion, your willingness to constantly be learning will take you very far in being a successful data scientist. The second mistake has to be learning a lot of theory without any application. So this is something I've seen a lot of people do, and I've also done that myself. At a glance, data science seems like a very academic field, and it's hard not to think like that when you're learning all of the statistics and working with colleagues that have PhDs. But in reality, in the commercial world, it couldn't be further away from the truth. I've said this many times in my videos, but the majority of data science that's conducted in a commercial environment is all about solving business problems. I mean, it's great to learn about the mathematical intricacies of generative adversarial networks, but always make sure to take a step back and look at the big picture and try to figure out how this cool AI technique could be applied for a practical solution. If you're enjoying the video so far, then consider subscribing. I make weekly videos about demystifying data science. The third mistake has to be diving into the code without a clear problem definition and plan. Early on in your data science career, it's all very tempting to start coding and build new things. And it's also very tempting to dive straight into the code without formulating a plan to solve the problem. I did this many times early on in my career, and it never ends well. You start writing the code, and a few days later, you realize that you didn't account for a very obvious use case. And now you have to rewrite the code in order to accommodate for it. Formulating a clear problem definition allows you to take a step back and frame the problem in many different ways. This will allow you to come up with the best solution to that problem and create a code and model design according to it. The fourth mistake I often see is seeking a complex solution rather than a simple one. When you study computer science or engineering at university, you learn about all of the cutting-edge algorithms along with very complicated maths. And this gets you in a habit of valuing complexity as though it's a badge of honor and a mark of intelligence. In the commercial data science world and the business world, you're tasked with finding a solution to the problem in the simplest way possible and not the most complex way, because that's a lot easier to explain to different stakeholders and it gives them more confidence in the solution. So in practice, this might mean opting for a logistic regression when it solves the problem adequately, as opposed to a neural network, which is inherently a black box algorithm. So really, as you become a data scientist, get into the habit of seeking simple solutions first instead of complicated ones. Now, the fifth mistake that I see often is not asking for help enough early on in your data science journey. Like Kenji says in his videos, struggling with data science problems early on in your career is a valuable part of the process. And this is something I definitely agree with, and it really applies when you're trying to learn new things. But sometimes in the work environment as a practicing data science, you might get stuck in a rabbit hole crawling through multiple Stack Overflow pages. This can be a great way of wasting your entire day trying to find a solution to a problem that your colleague could have helped you figure out in 5 minutes. I think Newton said it best, that standing upon the shoulder of giants helped him see further. The same analogy applies to learning and applying data science. A rule of thumb that I've typically applied is if it takes me more than 30 minutes to an hour to solve a particular problem, which could be a code debug or a code error, I always make sure to ask one of my colleagues in case they had faced the issue before or if they've got a quick solution. But when you're trying to learn new concepts, it can be beneficial to struggle a little bit initially. That's it for today. If you enjoyed the video, then smash that like button and I'll see you next time.